Hello students, I am Ghazala Shariq Hassan and till now we have completed our very first chapter, A Letter to God, and question and answer based on that chapter, and our first poem, Dust of Snow, and in that also we have done our literary devices and question and answer. Now we are heading towards our next poem, that is Fire and Ice. It has been written by Robert Frost. Now let's go through the poem. Some say the world will end in fire, some say in ice. From what I've tasted of desire, I hold with those who favor fire. So, as per the poem, the world will end in either of the two ways, either by ice or by fire. So here, let me tell you, fire symbolizes desire or wants, and ice symbolizes war or hatred. So there are some people who believe that the world will end because of excessive desire, and there are also some people who believe that the world will end because of hatred or war. From what I have tasted of desire, now who is I over here? Robert Frost, the poet Robert Frost himself is I over here, and he thinks, from what I have tasted of desire, I hold with those who favor fire. So, what is the opinion of the poet? The poet thinks, I believe, I agree with the people who believe that the world will end because of fire or because of excessive desire. So, poet is of the opinion, there are some people who believe that the world will end because of excessive needs or desire, wants. There are some people who believe that the world will end because of hatred or war. But what is the perspective of the poet? The perspective of the poet is, he believes that, he is agree with the people who believe that the world will end because of excessive desire. But if it had to perish twice, I think I know enough of hate to say that for destruction, ice is also great and would suffice. So, in the first stanza, it was very clear that there are some people who believe that the world will end because of excessive desire of people, and there are some people who believe that the world will end because of war or hatred. But what was the opinion of the poet? The opinion of the poet was, the world will end because of excessive desire. Now, in this stanza, there is contradiction. In this stanza, the poet says, if the world has to perish twice, if it happened to perish twice, perish means end, it happened to end twice, then he thinks enough of hatred or war is also sufficient to end the world. It means, in the first stanza, he was of the opinion that the desire, excessive desire, would destroy the world, will end the world. But in this stanza, he is of the view that if the world happened to end twice or the second time, so enough of hatred or excessive war would also cause the ending of the world. Now let's see the literary devices used in the poem. Now first one is assonance. What is assonance? It is repetition of vowel sounds in same line. The repetition is at different places in different words. So the long sound of O in I hold with those who. Hold those who. So here O sound is repeating in above lines, so there will be assonance here. Here alliteration is also used. Anaphora has also been used in the poem. Now what is anaphora? Anaphora, the repetition of a word or expression at the start of two or more consecutive lines. Some say is repeated at the start of lines. 1 and 2. Like some say the world will end in fire, some say the will end in ice. So some say is repeating, so here will be anaphora. Personification. Personification is to give human qualities to inanimate objects. In this poem, fire and ice are capable of destruction. Thus, the poet personifies fire and ice by giving them mind and power to destroy anything. So here is person. In the poem, Yamit